Welcome to this morning on Asake podcast, your daily dose of insightful conversation on current affairs, politics, and social issues. Please share and also follow us on social media at SiteZW. Now, stay tuned to today's episode.
A very good morning to you and welcome to this morning on Asake. My name is Nonhlanhla Mabiwa and of course I'm here with Brighton.
A very good morning to you. Yo, the weather just changed in Bulawayo overnight. I mean, I thought we're in summer now, but anyway, it's windy in Bulawayo. We're back in our jerseys. It's cold. Yeah, kunzima kole makwaza. Anyway, mamkachini, good morning to you guys. Welcome to the show. Today we'll be looking at the issue of local authorities again, because we are the closer to our local authorities. We are the ones who are not getting water for more than 120 hours. We are the ones who queue for long hours. We are the ones who are using bad roads. We are the ones who are using bad street lights and so on. So I want to know from you guys this morning, how can local authorities improve their revenue collection? Over the past years, we know that they've been trying to improve, to collect revenue through rates and so on. But now I want to know what innovative ways, well, they had bars, they had clinics and so on. But now, what should be done?
Let's hear from Lillian. Good morning.
Morning. I think on the issue of revenue generation, if they can, for instance, partner with like private investors and maybe operate bus companies and ban those combis, because that way, every day people need transport, obviously. So I think it's one form of revenue generation. And if we had reliable electricity in our country, it could also help them in aiding for green policies, you know, like using my hybrid buses or electric buses. So I think that's one way, if they really wanted, they could look at. I think that's my contribution.
Thank you so much, Lillian, for that.
In terms of revenue collection, right, most of them, they are relying on the issue of rentals, right? I'm paying my rents, right, water, and the land, value, and so on and so on. But people are struggling to pay their rentals. What can be done to encourage them to pay their rentals? Good morning to you, Bento.
Good morning. Councils must embrace new management systems so that they can operationalize efficiency in revenue collection and data recovery. Also, they need to go back to yesteryear where they were brewing beer, you know, beer halls, and make sure anyone who is supposed to pay levies in councils, whether it's fees, you know, they have to pay. They have to net everyone. You know, and they also need to issue a lot of licenses to traders. And the biggest way councils can also raise money is to service more land. You know, they should develop more land, because when you have land, you make them pay rates. Rates are the cheapest way of raising money for councils, because there's no service attached to them in future. It's just money coming for free. It's priceless. You only have administrative fees. And as you know, council's biggest revenue is rents. So they need to develop more land. There should be a talk with government to get more land. And this land has to be developed so that commercial residents will be paying rents. You know, rents are the biggest source of revenue for councils. And they need to also sort out their books so that they can sell paper on the stock exchange. Like, they can sell bonds to raise money to develop land. And in future, they will be just getting free money from rates. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Bento, for that. Good morning to you, Nick.
Good morning, everyone. I think there will always be the three T's of finance for any local government, right? It's taxes, which is the money that is transferred from national government to a city. That, I would say, in the foreseeable future, it's reasonable to assume that will be fixed and meager, right? It's insufficient. Then there is the transfers, which is things like donor money and that kind of stuff. That one is an opportunity perhaps for the poor households. And these days, I think it's stuff like climate finance that is kind of selling. It's possible to package some projects that the city wants to do with a kind of a rationale that looks like it's climate friendly, and see if donors can contribute. The third T out of those three T's is tariffs, which is the tariffs, of course, that the city levies to users of their services and its own revenue collection. That is a potential only in the future. What do I mean? I mean, for example, if you want to collect more revenue from water, from electricity, you find yourself in this impasse where you're currently not providing the services reliably. So the potential payers will say, we want a reliable service before you can pay. So what's reasonable is to first reasonable service that is reliable and then inculcate a culture of payment. That needs money. Now, when you go and look for external money, potentially loans, I'm more interested in exploring the possibility of a diaspora bond, then it has to be off the back of a promise that, look, current payers are not paying, but we believe that if we provide a reliable service right now, in a matter of a year or 2 years, they'll start paying a little bit more. And yeah, I'm thinking of middle income households to businesses. It can be done, but I do think potentially the idea to look into there is some kind of a third party, a public-private partnership of some sort. That third party is the bridge between the city, potentially some financiers, to just provide that trust that revenue will be collected more efficiently, and then maybe that third party raises some of the capital. And I'll end there, but I really do think that a diaspora bond is another way potentially to raise the capital to do these things on the back of the promise that residents in the future will be able to pay more. Thanks.
Thank you so much, Nick, for sharing. I'm seeing a comment from James Bond. James says the city council needs to build its own solar projects and remove ZESA. They can get a lot of revenue by supplying the city. Good morning, Mandaza Douglas.
Good morning, Said. There are some few ways of trying to collect the revenue. I think one unpopular one is trying to raise the rates to be able to get some of the money there from the rates, especially in terms of the business side, to increase the rates, for the residents as well. That's another way of trying to raise some money. I know people are finding very difficult at the moment in Zimbabwe to be able to try and do this. City Council can also have their own bonds and to be able to sell to local residents and the diaspora as well. Then that bonds, the money collected from the bond sale can then be able to be rejuvenated back into the economy. Building up of some of the swimming pools that can also collect revenue and activities for young kids. The city council creating gyms, rehabilitating some of the, like, for example, bite halls and some of the halls that the city council used to lease to people and hire for things. Then they can get also some of the revenues from there. The other thing is that the city council can also go into partnership and have buses as well, that they can have local buses, then they can charge the money and get some money to increase into the city council. With a private partnership, they can also create some recycling things, then recycle. I think other people are actually selling their waste for recycling, like the plastic bottles that are littering the whole cities, they can be used and then be sold as well to do recycling for the roads as well, to be used maybe for the roads and stuff like that. And building our own stadiums as well that could also generate more revenue. But for all this to happen, the government of the day need to be able to work together with the city council and give them a bit of backing as well in terms of the finances. Sake.
Thanks so much, Douglas, for that. Good morning to you, Tsepang.
Good morning, Brighton. There is need to look at the internal side of local authorities. We can always refer to the Auditor General's report. Imagine when a local authority does not have an updated asset register. Bulk of the revenue for local authorities is generated through a property and rates. So you need to know the property that you have within the city or within any locality. If you don't have an updated register, what it means is that some people may be staying in a particular building without paying, or they're actually paying less. I remember that recently, through the blueprint, no compromise to service delivered. One of the priority areas was to evaluate these properties. Evaluation of properties is one way of generating revenue, because people may be staying in a particular place, paying less, yet they are supposed to be paying more. And whether you pay less or more is determined by the evaluations that should be done from time to time. I was thinking of certain services that I think now need to be available within our clinics. If you want renal care, for instance, that should be available. Or you are supposed to go for a scan. All that should be available. So local authorities need to devise means of partnering with donors or utilizing the already existing diaspora community through creation of partnerships. Where I stay, there is a private clinic nearby, and the amount of money that they get through provision of health services, and I sit back and think, if that money could go to our local authority clinics, then there's a potential of generation of revenue when they are sufficient, or when there's sufficient equipment, where health issues are concerned. People are always going to pay. Thank you.
Thanks so much, Sepang, for that. Quite interesting what you are raising there. Good morning to you, Mibono.
Okay, Mina, I'm going to say there are a number of areas that we can work on as a city. I feel we are still hamstrung. We are still losing in mindset. Bulawayo is an industrial city. Bulawayo is a cultural city. And we are slowly losing that. Kates are still an industrial one. I'm in the stronger but the number 8 single. I want to wait. So I personally think we need to change Bulawayo strategy. Forget this whole industrialization thing. So what is here? Look at what other frontiers can we conquer? Allow Bulawayo to be a tech city. Imagine if Bulawayo was a tech city. Give ultimate incentive to tech companies to come to Bulawayo. Number two, allow Bulawayo to sweat its assets. See, our farms as a council. Our farms, what are they doing? See, Nkomo as a council. Nkomo, what are we doing? We're supposed to be doing Nkomo, like who can see when they make I want the Nkomo, that's like Tegisa, in Abuka. What are we doing with our assets? Our shops, at Tesla, or a town as a council. Are we sweating? Are we getting market rates? Or we say, what's imagine if you can train, let's say, 2,000 people with tech skills, which means they're going to develop things for us as a city. And in those applications, if Bulawayo has maybe an ownership, let's say 10%, because we train him to law, or have some model or some sort in which Bulawayo has an ownership of that thing that somebody is going to develop, which means country is going to have money, then we sweat our assets. For instance, I'll give you any example. We've got in Ascot, like, what are we doing with it? We've got a lot of land that council is not developing. Council can even have its own hotel. We're not doing much on that front. Council has got the caravan park, like, So culture has got a lot of assets that it has, but it's not sweating those assets. That is my thrust. That's what I think we should do as a council, sweat our own assets. Thank you.
Quite interesting ideas and solutions shared here today. It was lovely to have you guys on the show. Otherwise, from myself, Nonhlanhla Mabiwa.
And Bright Ogube.
It's bye for now.
Thank you for tuning in to this episode. For feedback, you can contact us on 263-777-47-0017. Don't forget to follow and like our social media pages.